Now, location and incidence of metastasis in the neck, it varies according to the primary site. Primary tumor within the oral cavity and the lip metastasizes invariably to level 1, level 2 and level 3 lymph nodes, that is submental, submandibular, upper jugular and middle jugular, with one exception, that if the lesion is present in the oral tongue, tongue has two portion, anterior 2/3 and posterior 1/3. Oral tongue means anterior 2/3. If the lesion is present in this area, it is possible that this might have skip metastasis. Skip metastasis means it's possible to have level 3 and level 4 involvement without involvement of level 1 and 2. That means the metastasis has skipped level 1 and level 2 lymph nodes. Now, the tumors of oropharynx, hypopharynx and laryngopharynx involves, it spares I will say level 1, but involves all jugular chains, upper, middle and lower, that is level 2, level 3, level 4. Isolated involvement of face of level 5 is unknown. If the tumor of oropharynx, hypopharynx or laryngopharynx, we may not find skip metastasis. Now, nasopharynx and thyroid, they spread to posterior nodes in addition to jugular nodes. I mean, level 2, 3 and 4 are involved and level 5 is also involved. Whereas, hypopharynx, cervical esophagus and thyroid, certain malignancies like medullary carcinoma thyroid, they involve level 6 and may extend sometimes to level 7 lymph nodes. So, this all knowledge is essential so that whenever you are seeing the cases, you can plan accordingly and you can manage accordingly. A word about philosophy of treatment of cervical nodes. Traditionally, gold standard for control of cervical metastasis is radical neck dissection, described by Kreils long ago. And a classical radical neck dissection, what we call as in short term as R&D, consists of removal of lymph node from level 1 to 5, means submental, submandibular, all three jugulars and posterior group of lymph nodes, along with removal of sternocleidomastoid muscle, internal jugular vein and 11th cranial nerve, that is accessory nerve. Now, then came modification of R&D, which is called as MR&D or modified radical neck dissection. In this, everything is same except preservation of non-lymphatic structures like 11th cranial nerve, that is accessory nerve, sternocleidomastoid muscle and internal jugular vein. So, if you preserve these three structures and carry out sweeping of all lymphatic tissue and structures, then this is called as MR&D. It is a functional dissection. It preserves the look of neck and contour relatively in a better position. There is another term called as selective neck dissection, SND. In this, neck node dissection that preserves lymphatic compartments, normally removed as part of radical neck dissection, is termed as SND or selective neck dissection. When you are preserving the structures and you are not taking out all the levels. Boca actually had demonstrated that results of modified radical neck dissection or functional neck dissection are equally effective in controlling regional metastasis as classical R&D. Results of MR&D and classical R&D are almost same. Subsequent data supporting use of selective neck dissection and modified radical neck dissection has suggested that these procedures have been preferred alternative for treatment of cervical metastasis. So, the principles of selective neck node dissection is that you preserve certain group of lymph nodes because specific primary sites preferentially drain their lymphatics in a predictable manner. As I said earlier, in earlier slides, the tumors of oropharynx, hypopharynx and laryngopharynx will involve level 2, 3, 4, thyroid, hypopharynx and cervical esophagus would involve level 6 and 7. Similarly, primary tumor from oral cavity and lip will metastasize to level 1, 2 and 3. So, you know, there is a predictable pattern of the lymphatic metastasis. You can see the primary, you can look at the secondaries, and if patient is presenting with primary tumor of say oral cavity, there is no need taking out posterior cervical lymph nodes because it is not involved. Now, what are the various types of selective neck node dissections? Selective neck node dissections are of three types. One is supraomohyoid dissection. In supraomohyoid dissection, it is generally used for oral cavity, primary lesions when they are located in the oral cavity, and it removes only level 1 and level 2 lymph nodes. Level 1, as I said, submandibular, this brown area, brown field is the field removed in selective supraomohyoid selective node dissection. You take out submandibular, submental and upper jugular, or that is what you call as jugulodigastic group of lymph nodes. And this is generally done for lesions of oral cavity. The second variety of selective node dissection is lateral neck dissection. In lateral neck dissection, you take out complete jugular chain, upper, that is level 2, middle, that is level 3, and the lower, that is level 4. So, this complete sweeping of the jugular chain, leaving aside level 1 and level 5, they are not disturbed, then you call it as a lateral neck dissection, as the name is obvious, situated mostly on the lateral side. What are the malignancies where you use this kind of clearance? Generally for laryngeal malignancies. The third type of selective node dissection is posterolateral neck dissection. Posterolateral, posterior as well as lateral, means you take out level 2, level 3, level 4 as well as posterior group of lymph nodes, that is level 5 lymph nodes present in the posterior triangle of neck. So, this much brown field is cleared in posterolateral neck dissection, and this is generally done for thyroid carcinoma, like follicular carcinoma, papillary carcinoma. Just to remind that medullary carcinoma is one exception, in the sense that clearance of central compartment nodes, that is level 6, and if it has gone to 7, picking up the lymph nodes in the 7th level is also important. But otherwise, for general common differentiated malignancies of thyroid, posterolateral neck dissection is sufficient enough. Now, another important aspect that needs mention here, along with the applied aspect of neck nodes, is that in clinically negative nodes, that is N0, if the risk of occult metastasis is more than 20%, I again repeat, in clinically negative nodes, if the risk of occult metastasis is more than 20%, then an elective treatment of nodes at risk is advised. What is the elective treatment? Either in form of a elective neck irradiation or elective neck dissection using selective node dissection. awareness of potential for skip metastasis, which is not uncommon for lesions on the lateral aspect of oral part of the tongue. It is very essential, and if this is there, it may require extension of standard neck node, selective neck node dissection to include the additional level of lymph nodes that has been involved. Say, as I said, that for oral malignancies and tongue, supraomohyoid dissection is involved. Supraomohyoid selective neck dissection is to be done. But suppose there is level 3 in addition that has also to be removed, especially if the case is presenting with a lesion at the lateral margin of the tongue, that is oral tongue. I think this is all what I have to say for scalp, head, face and neck as far as a general surgical practice is concerned. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Garg, for such a enlightening talk, and I'm sure the students must have benefited with it. So, sir, it's important that the students should at least do a very good clinical examination of the lymph nodes.
Yeah, it is because very important.
Very important. And
the only message that I want to convey through this anatomy of neck nodes is that it should not be a casual examination. They should examine lymph nodes at level 1, level 2, 3, 4, posterior, as well as central compartment. Thoroughness of the physical exam. Now, by knowing this anatomy, you have to learn one thing, that you have to be very thorough in your neck examination.
That's why they say that what the mind does not know, the eyes don't see. So if the anatomy is very good, they know the location of these lymph nodes, they know where to look them for. If they have the basics, they will definitely do a very good clinical examination of the patient.
In fact, you have spoken a very golden sentence with regard to basics. The eyes do not see what mind does not know. If you know the anatomy, if you know the pattern, then of course you will never fail in your physical examination to pick up the things. But if you do not know that, say for example, for medullary carcinoma thyroid, it can involve central compartment, it can involve posterior compartment, you will just carry out examination of submental, submandibular and jugular nodes. Here lies the importance of eyes do not know but mind does not know. That certainly applies to this area also.
Dr. Satish, would you like to add something for this talk for the benefit of DNB students?
Basically the examination and importance of clinical examination. This is the main point basically, and this applies more in head and neck area than in any other part of the body. So every student should carry out basic examination, clinical examination thoroughly, and I think Professor Pradeep Garg has covered most of the applied anatomy very well. That's all.
Students, if you have any queries relating to this topic which Dr. Garg has given, or if you have any specific queries on the surgery, you can always call us. You have the phone numbers of our studio. I'll repeat them once again. The phone number of the studios are 011, this is STD code, 2953-2844, 011-2953-2845. The toll free number is 1-800-112345. Please call us in case you have any queries, because students, we try to clear all your doubts. So in case you want to ask us anything, we have our panel of experts with us. They'll answer all your queries pertaining to this subject. So please call us and try to make the session as interactive as possible, because then only you have to learn. And it's must for all DNB students to attend these sessions and record these entries in their logbook. The logbook will be signed by the supervisor. So call up all your friends, tell them we're having a teleconferencing session in the subject of surgery, and we have very interesting topics lined up for you. So attend these sessions to inform all your friends. And for the next session, which will be on an applied surgery of the breast and intestine, which will also be taken by Dr. Garg. So in case you have any queries about that, you can also keep jotting down and you can call us anytime. Students, if you have any questions related to any specialties, You can also email us your queries. The email address is the specialty name nbe@yahoo.com. For example, for the subject of surgery, in case you have any academic questions related to surgery specialty, you can email us. The email address for the surgery would be surgerynbe@yahoo.com. In case you want to suggest some teleconferencing topics which you may feel are important and you are not very clear about them, you can email us for those subjects. The email address for teleconferencing is teleconferencingnbe@yahoo.com. So we take a break here, sir, for around 15 minutes, and we'll come back at 3:30 p.m. for our next session on applied surgery of the breast and intestine. So keep watching us. Tell all your friends to join in for this live teleconferencing session brought to you jointly by National Board of Examinations and Indira Gandhi National Open University. We take a break here. We'll see you at 3:30 p.m. So keep watching us and take care.